Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we have some brand new support that is dropping out of a brand new set in the OCG. We have Adagnister support, Cyberdark support, but then more importantly, we finally have some amazing Kariba support. So let's start with the least important to the most important. So let's start with Adagnister. So the first card we have is FAI. Fighting Spirit. It's supposed to be Fighting Spirit. I know it's dumb. So you can only activate one card with this card's name per turn. You can target one Adagnister monster in your graveyard, special summon it. Okay. If an Adagnister monster you control with 2300 more attack be destroyed by card effect, you can banish this card from your graveyard instead. So essentially this card is a revival of the Dragon Lords or whatever that card is, a monster born for dragon types. And then if this card is banished, you can activate this effect. Your Adagnister monsters with 2300 or more attack cannot be shown by battle this turn. Seems like a solid card, honestly. Then we have AI's Show. This is a normal trap. When an opponent's monster declares an attack, if you control a Link 3 or higher Adagnister monster in the extra monster zone, special summon any number of non-Link Cybers monsters with 2300 attack from your extra deck, whose total attack is equal to or less than the attacking monster's attack, then end the battle phase. I don't know why this is a card, quite honestly, because it's like, if you have a Link 3 or higher Adagnister on the field, shouldn't you already be winning the game? I don't play Adagnisters, I really don't know what they do at all, but I wanted to cover it anyway, but I don't see the point of this card. Like, shouldn't you already be winning at that point? Then we have two new cards for Cyberdark support. Get the fuck out of here, ads. Why's your organization? Stop with your fucking ads, honestly. We have a Roid support card, and then we also have this card. Oh, I don't want to enlarge it because I don't want the ads to pop back up, but I love this artwork. Zane played this card in his duel against Cyrus. Oh, always love this artwork. So the first card we have is Dragon Roid. It's a level 8 wind machine monster, 2900 attack, 1000 defense. You can only use this card's name's first effect once per turn. So you can discard this card and activate one of these effects. You can add one non-wind Roid monster from your deck to your hand. That seems pretty good. It's any Roid card, so I'm assuming you could also get like Speed Roids, the regular Roid monsters, things like that. You could search Drill Roid, I think, because I'm pretty sure it's Earth, but I could be wrong. Because, you know, people are searching for Drill Roid in 2021. Anyway, this turn, the activation of your cards and effects that include an effect that fusion summons a fusion monster cannot be negated. Also, your opponent can activate cards or effects when a monster is fusion summoned this way. Then its second effect is once per turn this card's in your grave, you can make this card in the graveyard become a dragon monster until the end of this turn. So, in theory, you're going to play this with Cyberdarks. You can ditch it to use its effect to let it not be responded to, and then make it a dragon to attach with Cyberdark Dragon. I really like this card. This card's good. Like, you can either use it to search for a non-win Roid, which I don't think that's ever going to happen. You're just going to use it for its magical meltdown effect. And then, on the next turn, you can only use this card's name's first effect once per turn. So I think you could also use the secondary effect as well to make it into a dragon. So, that seems pretty good. And then we have, essentially, a DNA surgery for the graveyard has always been what it was. This is Declaration of a Birth, and it's a continuous trap. Once per turn, you can declare one type. All monsters in the graveyards become the declared type till the end of this turn. Zane used this in the anime when he dueled against Cyrus. He made all the monsters in the graveyard dragons, and then his Cyberdark Dragon just got immensely beefy. So, I think it's a cool card. I've always loved the artwork. And next up, we have what's really important here. We have the five Kariba brothers. The Kariba siblings finally arrive. So they all have the same stats. They're all level 1 Dark Fiend effect monsters with 300 attack and 200 defense, and they all have the same effect that they're always treated as a Kariba card. And look at these little puffballs. We finally have Kariba Babylon. We finally have 5-star fucking Twilight. Let's go. I am going to tribute a Baphomet to summon these dudes in 2021. Let's go. So, for this is Kariba. You can only use this card's name's first effect once per turn. When this card or a Kariba monster you control is destroyed by battle, you can special summon one monster with 300 attack, 200 defense from your deck except itself. I hate the fact it has to be destroyed by battle, because who the hell is destroying Kariba by battle, but anyway. You can tribute this card to control plus 4 monsters from your hand and or field, one each of Kariba, 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 and Kariba, special summon a Kariba Babylon from your hand to your graveyard. I like the fact that it's both from the field and the hand. The only issue is that I feel like getting the 5 Kariba brothers together is going to be like trying to get the 5 pieces of Exodia in your hand together. But let's go through the rest of these and then we'll discuss. Then we have Kariba. You can only use its name's first effect once per turn. When this card or your Karibo monster is destroyed by battle, you can add one spell or trap that specifically lists the card Karibo in its text from your deck to your hand. Guys, don't shit yourself, but we can search for multiply. We can make link plays. I don't know how good that's going to be in today's day and age, but it's an option. We can now search for multiply and anything else that lists Karibo. Actually, now that I think about it, we could also search for... Could we search for... Well, we couldn't search for Wing Karibo, but I think we could search for Transcendent Wings. Because it says specifically list the card Karibo. So wouldn't Wing Karibo technically be a Karibo because its name is Karibo? I don't know. And then once per turn when the opponent's monster declares an attack, if you control another Karibo monster, which when are you ever going to do that, you can change the attack of all the face-up monsters you currently control to zero until the end of the turn if you do negate the attack. I don't really understand that second effect because, I mean, why would you... you know, want to decrease all of your monsters to zero just to stop one attack. You know, if you're going against something like Dragon Link and they got four monsters, three of which can attack and one of them's a Heavenly Spheres, you know, why are you going to drop all yours to zero just to stop one attack? It just doesn't make any sense. Then we've got Karibu. Look at that adorable little bastard. When an opponent's monster declares an attack, you can discard this card, add one Karibo monster from your deck to your hand except Karibu. Once per turn quick effect, you can discard one trap, then target one face-up monster your opponent controls. It loses 1500 attack until the end of this turn. So... why 1500? I don't know. I guess because Curry Babylon is 1500. you can also cheese this thing because the opponent goes to attack with something. You go, okay, I'm going to ditch. I'm going to add Karibo, and then I'm going to ditch that Karibo since you get a replay to make your monster's attack be nullified. So something to point out there. Then we have Curry Bay. Look at this man going to work. quick effect, you can discard this card, then target one Karibo monster you control gains 1500 attack. So right off the bat, any of your Karibo brothers are going to be 1800 with this thing. They gave the deck a Kaloot, which I think is pretty solid. You contribute this card to control plus four monsters from your hand and or field, one each of Kariba, Karibi, Karibu, and Karibo. Add one Karib Bandit from your deck or graveyard to your hand. Then immediately after this effect resolves, you can normal summon one fiend monster from your hand. I like how it doesn't say you have to normal summon the Karib Bandit because you can summon any fiend monster you want, but you're most likely going to be summoning Karib Bandit. I don't know how Karib Bandit would really work well in a straight-up Karibo deck, because, I mean, it's meant to excavate five through your deck. But maybe you can combine them with the God cards. You know, think about it. This is always treated... all the Karibo brothers are treated as Karibo cards. So you search Multiply, play Multiply, get out five tokens, tribute three for Slifer. It could work. I don't know. It sounds really cheesy, but you never know. We finally have Curry Babylon. Level 5 Dark Fiend effect monster, 1500 attack, 1000 defense. You can only use either this card's name's first or third effect per turn, and only once that turn. If you have more monsters in your graveyard than your opponent does, you can special on this card from your hand. Hey, a level 5 Fiend extender, just that you're able to drop it out if you're going second, that seems pretty good in and of itself. Gains 3 attack and defense for each Karibo monster you control and in your graveyard. So right off the bat, if you summon this with the 5 Karibo brothers, in the words of Raphael from the anime, that's one big puffball you got there. This thing becomes 3,000 attack. Holy balls. And then if you want to be like Yamayugi and combine it with the Seal of Orichalcos, this shit's 3,500. Oh my god. And if you think about it too, since it's 300 attack and defense for each Karibo monster you control, if you're running three of them things each, yeah, that's going to be one big puffball. During your main phase or battle phase, quick effect, you can turn this card to the hand if you do special summon one Kariba, B, Boo, and Bay, and Karibo from your hand in or graveyard in attack mode. So he can dissolve himself into the original 5 Karibo brothers. I don't know how useful that is. You know, if the opponent goes Dark Hole or something, it's really not going to be helpful. If you're in the battle phase and you need more defense, then you can bring them all out in attack mode. I still don't really know how good that is. Then we finally have the 5-star Twilight. This is the card that Yamayugi tributed his Baphomet to get out the 5 Karibo brothers with. And if you have not watched that duel where Raphael beats Yamayugi and he was showing off the Karibo brothers, watch that one, then watch the rematch. It's so damn good. If the only monster you control is one level 5 monster, tribute it. Special summon one of each of the Karibo brothers from your hand, deck, or grave, but they cannot be tributed for a tribute summon. You can only activate one card with this card's name per turn. I mean, I don't see how you could even use multiple. So this right off the bat can convert a level 5 to all 5 Karibo brothers. Now, if you want to be somewhat competitive with this, I don't suggest you play things like Curry Babylon or Curry Bandit. You're better off just like dropping this out of your hand as a special summon if the opponent has more stuff in their grave. So, maybe like make a ghost second Karibo deck or something. Drop this out, use the 5-star Twilight to tribute it, get the 5 Karibo brothers and make a Link 4, a Link 5, make Link plays. Make a Link Karibo, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, there's a lot of options here, and I think it's really, really interesting. And it's actually funny that they printed these now, because in a video that I was going to upload, but I ended up not. I was talking about cards that I wish that Konami would make into real cards, and one of them was 5-star Twilight along with the 5 Karibo brothers, because they're just so iconic. They're just so cool. And so to finally have these now, in real forms, is really, really cool. Now they are coming out. AC01 stands for Anime Collection, I believe. We did not mean to do that. It stands for Anime Collection, if I can find it. It says AC01, but they don't have. I guess they don't have where it comes from, but I know that technically it's called like Anime Collection or something, or Animation Collection. So if they release more things out of this set, we're going to probably see more things coming out of the anime. So what kind of cards would you want to be seen printed? If it's a collection of stuff from the anime, honestly, we're starting off good with the 5 Karibo brothers. We need, and I'm calling it now, we need more Orichalcos support. We need Orichalcos Gyges. You don't even need to give us the Great Serpent. Just give us the second and the third ring of the Seal of Orichalcos. Give us Orichalcos Qtora. Give us Orichalcos Gyges. Konami, blow the doors off of this animation collection set. You will make so much fucking money if you do this right. Give us the Orichalcos monsters that we need so bad in our lives. Maybe you don't need it, but I sure as shit do. I want to be able to summon my Mirror Knights, put Joey's Wheeler's face on one of the Mirror Knights, make you question attacking it because you're gonna lose his soul forever. I mean, just there's so much that they can do. So let me know what you think of these cards. Let me know what you want to see come out of the set. I'm geeking out. Like the 5 Kariba brothers, they're not gonna be good. Like the most you're gonna probably do is just drop out Curry Babylon, use 5-star Twilight, make a Link 4 play, maybe a Firewall, or maybe a Nightmare Griffin. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think about this in the comments. Thank you so much for watching and subscribe if you have not already.